And I guarantee you, when you become better at Melodyne, you'll become a better mixer. Promise.
Let's take a drive and go somewhere.
Hey guys, welcome to MixCoach.com. Today I'm going to be exploring a new feature in Melodyne that's one of my favorite features that they've come out with. It's called ARA, Audio Random Access, and it's a game changer as far as using Melodyne, but I wanted to tell you really quickly about a free resource I've got. It's a cheat sheet, if you will, for Melodyne. So mixcoach.com/Melodyne. The link is in the description. Click it and go get your free shortcut and cheat sheets, okay? Anyway, okay, so let's talk about ARA as it pertains to Pro Tools and Melodyne. Melodyne is one of my favorite plugins. SSL is one of my favorite plugins too, but Melodyne is in a league of its own because did you know that most people, a lot of singers, when they don't like something, it's usually not your EQ or your compression or even your level sometimes. Sometimes it's something that's bothering them in the way they performed it. Melodyne can solve that problem for you. In the last decade or so, mixers have become editors as well. If you're not already a part of composing the music and writing it and recording it, then for sure by the time you get it, some editing may be required. If you know Melodyne, you can be way ahead of the curve because you can actually fix some of those things that bother vocalists that they don't even know is bothering them, like a little trail off on a pitch, or they didn't reach a certain note when they went for it, or they were just ahead of the beat. That's why I love Melodyne, because I can go and fix that. There's a ton of stuff that you can do with Melodyne. We're just going to be talking about vocals, and we're just going to be talking about the ARA feature in Melodyne for vocals, okay? So back in the day when Melodyne first came out, you had to go and instantiate a plugin. So you'd go down here. This is Holly Winter, by the way. Thank you, Holly, for letting me use your song. Now, Holly doesn't need to be tuned, but I'm using hers because she's just got the coolest sounding vocal. So what you had to do in the past, you had to go in and you had to insert on the first channel Melodyne. So I just searched for Melodyne and you'd hit it. And then you'd have to go in here and put this in record. And then you'd have to either put the track in record and just listen to the whole thing, go get some coffee. If your ADD kicks in, you go do something. And 3 hours later, you come back and you try to figure out where you were and you start mixing, right? Well, there's also a hack where you can act like you're printing it to tape and then, or bouncing it to disk or committing it, and it will do it faster than real time. But there's still a purpose for that. If you just want to do one little phrase and the rest of the track is perfectly fine, then use the plugin version of Melodyne instead. But most of the time, when you are using Melodyne, you want to take the whole track into Melodyne and you want to tune it. Well, here's where ARA, or Audio Random Access, comes in. And it's such a tight integration. You're going to love it. You're going to love it. Okay, so down here, The upside down funnel, as I call it, is the place where you would go to do elastic time. And the ones that I use are polyphonic, rhythmic, and monophonic. I hardly ever or have never used any of the other things unless I was just completely bored and wanted to really mess up a track. I only use these top three. Well, if you go down a little further now, you'll see Melodyne. And I think Melodyne actually comes with a lot of versions of Pro Tools now. Now, it's not the advanced Melodyne, and I'm not sure what the differences are in what I've got and what you would get, but for all intents and purposes, it would be the same. You'd do the same thing. But what we're going to do is go to Melodyne, and watch how quickly this happens. I'm going to release the word Melodyne, and just like that, Melodyne has tracked all your vocals in. It's ready now to start manipulating pitch and time. And, you know, you can edit to your heart's content. If you want this screen to go away, you can hit Option 8 on a Mac, and it goes away. Now, if you notice on the track, I'm going to hit E to make it enormous. If you notice, there's a couple of spots. There's some little UFOs in the sky above the horizon here. Those are the notes that Melodyne has detected that Holly is singing here. And you can right-click on this, and you can go to Melodyne and then edit, and you can get that screen back and you can go and edit her vocal ever how you want to. and then it will reflect that in the audio file. You can also go in here, let me hit option 8 and make this go away. It's so tightly integrated into Pro Tools that you can go in here and say you're not going to use this, you're going to just delete it. Well, if you go into Melodyne, and for this, for how I'm going to get it up this time, I'm just going to click on the word Melodyne, and this will pop up again. If you notice here, this whole section that I just deleted is no longer in Melodyne, so you don't have to worry about it. If you wanted to, let's say, close this and crossfade this, Melodyne is going to play that back just like you're doing it in the audio file. The thing I didn't, the workaround with Melodyne when you're using it as a plugin is you always have to remember that Melodyne is last, and you can delete the audio file if you want to, and it will still play back if you track the whole audio file into Melodyne, which is good and bad. It's good if you accidentally erase the whole vocal file because it will still play back and you can just bounce it. It's bad most of the time because when you're trying to wrangle in a mix very quickly, you now have two places that you have to go to edit the vocal. So I think the ARA version, or the latest integration of Melodyne with Pro Tools, is so good because they talk hand in hand. For instance, if I wanted to take this phrase here and clip gain it up like this, Melodyne now plays that clip gained version. If you wanted to clip gain it down, I use clip gain all the way to the last minute of mixing a lot of times, and I want Melodyne to take that into account. If you did a crossfade, Melodyne will play it back. So anyway, I love this part of Melodyne. I think it's really good. I love the ARA integration in with Pro Tools. It's not a brand new thing, but it's something that I use all of the time. So if you've liked this video, let me know about it. And if you would like to know some shortcuts on how to use Melodyne more efficiently, and you would like to even download some of my key bindings because you can create your own shortcuts. I have shortcuts where I control Melodyne with these four fingers. So I have things mapped to my QWERTY keyboard and my mouse, and I can sit and tune a vocal really quickly by using what video editors use when they're editing. So, and that's just to keep everything tight. You're not having to look for menus and things. That's free. All you have to do is go to mixcoach.com/Melodyne. The link is in the description. You can go and download it and start getting to be more efficient in Melodyne. And I guarantee you, when you become better at Melodyne, you'll become a better mixer. Promise. Okay? All right. Hope this has been helpful, and I hope to see you again very soon. Okay? Bye. Let's get lost, baby.